Good morning, folks. Let's start with 2 days ago, Tuesday. During the worst parts of the geomagnetic disruption from the multiple solar eruptions that hit Earth, the aviation radar system of New Zealand went down. All of it. The entire sky was shut down, and there's currently no explanation for this internal network glitch, except that this is precisely the type of thing you worry about with solar storms. Normally, the KP would have had to hit 9 to see damaging effects, but elements of this storm were novel, including the fact that Earth's protective magnetosphere is weakening. We also saw a terrific forebush decrease during that impact, a drop in galactic cosmic rays. CMEs are giant clouds of plasma and charged particles, and when it hits Earth and surrounds us, it acts to block out galactic energy like a temporary second shield. You can see that effect here. Then, just this morning, boom, the largest yet, an M7.9 erupts from AR-2371. I can see already that the CME is Earth-directed and will strike our planet. Just look at the breadth of the ripple effect here. It's way too early to guess impact time, and the satellites need to update further, so keep your eyes on spaceweathernews.com today for details. Also, if you want alerts sent to your phone for these major events, follow me on Twitter, Ben@TheRealS0S. It is linked for you below this video as well. No spam, no nonsense tweets, just vital updates during significant events. We're still not done yet. The fourth CME struck yesterday, and it took a long time to do anything. I questioned whether it was even the CME at all. But the energy is finally creating more geomagnetic storm conditions, and the magnetometer appears to be going off the charts again. That's fun. The top stories today include water on Comet 67P. Large patches have been imaged by Rosetta, and it is linked for you below. The top earthquake of the day was a near six-pointer that struck Alaska, where their wildfire situation is out of control. Actually, from there down through SoCal and Arizona, the fires accompany this crazy heat wave. Got video and a cool fire map linked for you below to go check out on your own time. The convergence in the central U.S. wraps back down through Mexico while the flow out of the Gulf remains. It will shift east slightly tonight and bring the severe weather to these locations here. Europe. Two big lows, and they're even more visible on satellite than they were on the wind map. Weather shares from the islands, please. Down under, we see two highs oddly converging air masses between nations there. The clouds follow it perfectly. Got some current conditions and shots of our star to close. The sun isn't done just yet. It's 6:30 a.m. Eastern time, and that's the news. Eyes open. No fear. Be safe, everyone.